Alright, how you guys doing out there? Sorry about this. There you go. Well, we had a bit of a technical difficulty, so I was just shooting everything and I had no audio for some reason. But anyway, so we just took this machine apart, well, a quad away. This one was missing the bezel for the CD-ROM, which is this little guy here. And very happy on the fact that it does fit, which is very, very nice. This machine has been sitting on a project bin for God knows like almost 6-7 months, hoping to get a bezel for it and get a hinge cover with this guy, because that one was missing. So this is all good now. So Michael, this machine is good to go now. So now we're up to 3 iMac G3 clamshells, fully restored. So we have the Japanese version. One that for some reason there's a piece of the plastic that broke, so we had to rebuild it. Change the bottom case. That one was entertaining. And I'm like, oh, look at that. It's going to be an easy way to fix this. Not. So anyway, so before all the incident happened, because anyway I had no audio, this basically is all the latest tote that I got, I received it roughly about 2 or 3 weeks ago, and more parts the better, so we can revive more machine. I have another SE model of those. We have audio this time? Yes, we do. Anyway, so I do have an SE. Where did I put it? Oh, here it is. So I'm missing the hard drive, no CD-ROM. And we'll see, because I know I had the CD bezel for the end of it, and I just can't find it. Anyway, we'll figure it out. So anyway, so that one is an SE model. So anyway, so if you guys do have some, you know, like iBook G3 clamshells that needs to be fixed and all, just send it to me. I know there's a lot of people, and I'll say it over and over again, that a lot of people are intimidated by these little machines because there's a whole whack of screws, different size screws, holding brackets, and the list goes on and on and on. And, oops, no, it's not sitting, it's little thingy there. So anyway, they're fun to work on. There. Are you in there? Yes. Dude, that's such a bummer I didn't have the audio earlier. My goodness. But anyway. It does happen. Technical difficulties. Okay, so I'll just lock her up. Oops, that's the wrong guy. I don't want you. I want you. There. this little guy is very happy. And I'm very happy. Sadly enough, I don't think I've got an extra screen for that model here. I can't check if the motherboard is working. It does have the RAM on it. What's the other one that I just took apart yesterday? Oh, that one is not an SE model. Just a regular one. Oops, don't do that again. That's a 366 for this guy. This guy got no clue, but we will find out soon enough. That one is a 466. It's too bad they don't have a SCSI port. Oh, on the other hand too, if you guys know of anyone, because I did mention some of the stuff that I'm looking for, a dock for these little guys, more Lacie tower, whether if it's RAID or the one I'm working on, which is a 1080 model base, comes with, I think it's a 1.08 meg hard drive built in, but sadly enough the hard drive failed, which is this guy right here, which is a 50 pin SCSI. So as you can see, that one says 1080 for Lacie. Now it spins, but it doesn't seek any data. Yeehaw, this is epic. Still looking for its stuff, there you go. I just want to make sure the clicker is working. Good. Cool. Back to its original states. Okay, so no more of this. This is done. So three iBook G3 fixed. Now, this guy I'm not entirely sure what to do. I don't think I've got any more bottom case for this guy because it's cracked. Sadly enough, the one I just fixed up on yesterday, also actually accidentally damaged piece on one side, and I think I'm out of those color one, but it is overall working, so I'm gonna have to say for now we are done with it, unless once I get back from the storage, I might probably have a bottom case for this because she's in pitiful shape. This I don't like. It's disgusting, it's ugly. But we'll say four fixed. What else can we do? We can test if this guy's working. Let's bring a screen. Power inverter. See, for as long as you, when you do replace a screen, like I said on my previous videos, you're gonna have to keep the same ribbon. Because, oh, there you go. No, there's four. Or three models. Anyway, I know there's an IBM, Samsung, and LG. I'm not sure if HP does also screens. I think they do. I'm not 100% sure. But there's different brands out there, so whenever you do a screen replacement, make sure that you keep the ribbon. Ah, come on, buddy. Okay.
bummer. Why is the pin damaged? Oh, that's what it is. It's damaged. All right. Let's go and try to fix her up. Yeah, the tree here just bent the crap. All right. Let's have a quick look at it real quick. Like the two here are totally bent. And I'm like, why is this not going down there? It sure wasn't me. Alright, so those pins are back in there. Okay, let's do this again. That's better. Alright, so I don't really need a ground for this guy anyway. Everything's backward. Okay. I guess we could try one of those hard drives. Give them a try. Because eventually, every one of them is going to have to be tested. So, cute. Then we're supposed to have 921, 922, 921. You know what? I don't really care. 921 looks like the dual OS on that guy. Gig. It looks like they might all be working. Let's open up the other guy. ST922 loaded. This I like. Thank you very much, whoever's doing this. Like putting all the information. It's just freaking fantastic. Whoever did this, thank you very much. That saves me a whole whack of time to try to figure out whether this is working and what it's got in it. That one's got 10, 4, 11. I think it might probably be a little bit too much for this guy. Actually, it is a SC. It should be able to take it. Okay, so let's do 922 from this guy. That is the not so fun part. There. Put power on there. We got a green light. I think I might as well just. Where did I put that? I need a mouse. Oops, not you. Oh, shoot, that's right. I just reorganize all my. Suddenly I face a bunch of projects that I'm going to work on, so I got two of these. They've got a flickering screen. One of them boots, but it's got a black screen. None of those guys are working, and I've got quite a few of those. So I think I've got one, two, three, and four. None of them are working. I'll see how it goes. I think there's only one which it's got. Oh, let's use this guy. I haven't used this little guy for a long time. Matt Kelly? USB.
screen is popping, you'll get a happy finder. 9292, which is good. Looks like the motherboard is working. The only thing I'm hoping is it didn't put any password on it. Cool. So it looks like they did install a fresh, I'm aware of that. Okay. Yeah, sadly enough, I just cannot use this screen for rebuilding the other guy or this guy. Like, I need a spare screen for doing exactly what we're doing here, see whether or not the other motherboard is working. So I just can't use the screen, or else I'm just totally done. There's no way for me to see whether or not the logic board is working, or if the screen is defective, or the whatever. You know what I mean. Like, for diagnostics, I need to have a spare part. So this guy's the only one left that I got. So excellent, it is working. So, which is a good thing. Now it's just a matter of these hard drives are all working, so it's going to be in a storage bin. So this board itself is working. Which is very good. So I'm going to see if I can find a big, huge anti-static bag for this. Back in the project bin you go. Oops. Care. You know what? You could go in that project bin too. There you go, project bin. All right. So what else can we do? Yes, most of those machines are already done. So we got four iMac G3s, clamshells. Done. And let's see if we can revive the Lacie. See whether or not it's going to be working. I don't have, and I don't feel like working on these guys, to be honest with you. This guy is a mess. Let's do Lacie. The fan, actually, I just found out that the fan doesn't work on this. Which is, you know, kind of a bummer, because I did put a 6-volt in it, and it still won't spin the fan, so I think the fan is spooged. So I just glued this rod in it. Now the only thing which is bugging me is
hard drive itself, because it's got a front panel, and the front panel, for some reason, it's not holding anything at all, because it's got that little emblem that says 1080 on it, but it's silly enough, it doesn't work. Now, let's have a quick look at this. So power-wise, I'm reading all the proper power. So,
oh hi, is that a little screw?
No, plastic piece from the Lacie. So, what I'll do is, I'll bring that, because I got a ribbon actually, it's soon going to be coming. Oh my goodness, I just don't want to do this, I'm going to probably pull the entire thing, there you go. Because this little guy is damaged, I'm missing the back end of it. So let's put that bad boy back in there. And it's pointless to actually do this, because, oh hang on a minute. I wonder if we can get another. Actually, you know what? Just hang tight for a sec. I'm just gonna get my my book here, man. I'm going pretty much everywhere to find some parts for this guy, and they're really, really hard to find. Oh my god, more parts? Seriously? Those are the clips that are missing. Gorgeous. Okay, so this is from Sweden. You guys are not looking at my password, right? Okay, let's look for just two ends, no only one. And this is not a big one either. So the volume number is KDE 1204. PKS2. Jamico Electronics, looks like we might be able to get one. That is such a tiny little fan. I mean, if the price is fine, it's weight, height, and width. It's a 40 mil. I don't have my caliper. Looks about right. I mean, these are not the greatest, but for now it does the trick. I don't have a ruler either. What is the voltage anyway? Airflow, it's a 12 volt, but I'm reading only 6 volts coming out of there though. Anyway, let's put it back together. But it is available, which is good. I haven't actually got the chance to check my other tower. I've never actually taken that guy apart. It may or may not be compatible. So this is the panel that I'm talking about, because there's no way that I can glue this on this guy. Because this panel actually just sits right in front of it, or it clips on the front end of it. So, but anyway, we'll see how it goes. This is the right one. So I mean, like, considering it was cracked the heck out of it, because I had a bit of a quarter of that piece was missing. This was cracked beyond almost repair. Like, you can barely notice it unless you actually flip it. But this came actually really close to actually be another piece. We're able to wiggle it, but thank God it's fixed. Oh, it goes this way. Interesting. Other one. Here's the little screw. Of course, that one's not magnetized. You should be magnetized. There. Centronis, I believe that's what it is. But this little plug here, but I do have one coming up. I think it came with a pack of five. But what I'll be doing later, because the guy that did sell me this, that gave me also me the partial refund, you know, I think the money is going to be pretty much towards this little guy here, because the ribbon is, I don't know, it's not in good shape. It got damaged when you actually tried to clean them up. Which, you know, it's fair. Like, he was fair, and he did admit that he did damage some few things, which is how I like people. If you're honest, you're an amazing guy. Okay, so for now, I'll just put it on there. And this is very sharp. Do not fall in there. Thank you. So I'm just gonna do this. Hopefully it's not gonna be too much of a pain. And please do not break. I just fixed you up. Yeah, that is the only sad part about this. There you go. Back in place. Now it's a matter of trying to get the other guy in there. We still have a bit of that wiggle room in there, so we'll just flip her over. See? Thing of beauty. So the small ones right up front. I don't want to put too much pressure on it, I don't want to break it. The rubber feet are actually in pretty good shape. So for those that wants to know, well, actually it is an LEC. I didn't know that. Look at that. LEC 3005, part number 210582. We learn every day. I'll bring my tower actually over here. I don't recall what the part number is or the model. Okay, so let's bring the other, where's my little picker? Let us see if we could. I don't think she's gonna be working with me. That's funny because we got that little in and out, but we do have the other top piece that goes and sit right on top. Actually, hang on a minute. What was that piece that I had earlier? This guy. Does that fit in there? I don't think it will. Nope. Bummer. I got a feeling I gotta go and take it apart. Again. It's just, this is not the obvious part to take care of. Let's take it apart and see what can be done. Well, you know what? I think it's just silly me. Hang on a minute. There's a fix for this. So, it will. Uh-oh, I got a bad feeling about this. Oh, I got a bad feeling about this. Did it fail with it? Oh, good. Okay, well, it's not bad. Good. Okay, that's good. Okay, I had to freak out. Hopefully, it didn't break the plastic. So, this is not a bad fix. Come on now. That's an easy one. Oh, I can just leave it in there. Where's my plier? I need a plier. Actually, you know what? No, never mind. I think this piece actually did come off. Because it's loose in there. Oh, hang on a minute. It does. Good. Again, we learn every day. I think this time it's going to be a little easier to install the other guy. And I've never taken any of those before apart, so this is my first. Like even the big one that I got, I've never taken that guy apart. Those that never took any of those apart before, well, you kind of learn with me. thing, that was the problem. I couldn't actually fit that case in there properly because of that adapter. So let's put her back in there. Okay, so now we can put it back there. I don't understand why it's got a different thread. Unless you guys know, I actually have a good company that do sell ribbons, and the SCSI. I'll be looking for. I got a feeling that I might probably need quite a few of those, because that one is roughly about 10 inches long. That one might actually have a little bit longer, like 12, 15. And I can actually use one of those adapters in it with these two SCSI port. Let's see if we can just open it up. That easy. Okay, you come back here. There you go. So this should pop right back in there. So we don't need to actually over tighten this guy. It is going to be taken apart again, so. I'm glad the other one actually is holding really good, so it's a good fix. Sadly enough, in the process of doing it, just found out that we have more plastic broken piece. This I knew. But now it's a matter as of what can be done. It broke. Bummer. Yeah, we'll figure out something. I'm not gonna put it super tight in there. I'm just gonna put it just to say that it's gonna hold it. But if you have actually tricks to actually glue plastic back together just close to its original state, please do share. I'd like to know. Not too tight, I don't want to break it. But this is what it looks like. Now the cover, usually it sits here, but I think that's what happened, like the pins that was in there and some clips actually just are broken, but usually that's where it sits at. So that's a big bummer that it's broken. Spot. And another piece of plastic that broke somewhere in there. Alright, let's do this guy. Also, this little piece, I do have some broken piece. Got a clips here missing. That is missing one out of two. I'm not sure if these guys are supposed to be in there, but anyway, so that's There you go, buddy. Shall we try to connect the computer on it? I could try my blue and white. Or we can easily just call it a day and see for more projects coming up. I think that's pretty much what's going to happen because I haven't ate yet. And we're falling into the afternoon with no breakfast and this is not a good thing. But there will be an update on this little guy for sure. And yeah, definitely will keep you guys updated. And hopefully it's going to work. Cross fingers. And we'll order more parts for, you know, I just hate leaving you behind doing this. That's not fair. Hang on. Okay, let's do this. Let's connect the computer. And then we'll call it a day. Shall we do the all-in-one one? Okay, sorry for the mess and the noise. I have to move quite a few things to get to the machine. Okay, we will get the Mac Effect Mac SE converted machine. Hopefully I'm not going to destroy anything in the process. On it. You guys know this machine, right? You've seen it. So now the question is whether or not this is going to work straight from there, or do we use another adapter to make it work? Is that a screw? It is a screw. And another one nicely coiled. Just bear with me here. I know, right? iMac G3 power plug for this little guy. Right. Sadly enough, I kind of need to know if the thing is going to be working. Because he claimed the hard drive was working, but it's pretty much on his last leg. So, we'll give it a try. Now, let's go get a we'll just switch you guys here a little bit. Okay, so let's go get a keyboard. I like this guy. That's my favorite keyboard. And some mouse. Oh, actually, hang on a minute. I do have one. I do have a cable for it. Woo-hoo. Hopefully it's going to work. And I need it. That's right. I'm going to move all my stuff again. Because the mouse is buried in my filing cabinet. Mouse.
Can I move all this stuff out of the way?
Apparently not. Oh my goodness. I thought I nicely coiled these guys. What's wrong with mice? They move around. Alright, please contain yourself.
almost connected. And that one of my favorite. Okay, so we have power. Let's see if it works. It doesn't beep because it doesn't have the speaker on it. She doesn't read it because I think it's got an issue with this cousin. Okay. Let's try, pardon me, let's try the other port. Because that's one thing I hate about those machines. It's like it's not all SCSI. Device works on those Mac SEs. Now, let's see. Let's disconnect this guy. Connected and secure. All right, let's give it a try again. If we have a sign of life. Well, it's looking for a system, which is good. There you go. So now it's booting. Yes, the blue shining is actually the LED from the hard drive. It's pretty cool. Hey, you know, it's just like, it's a custom Mac SE, and you might as well do some custom blue LED. Okay, let's see if she's gonna work. Yeah, I think the hard drive is failing. Boom. So that's a boot from it. I think the fact that hard drive is failing, I don't think we're gonna see anything, but
gentle double click. Alright.
Yeah, let's try to put power on there.
So I think the hard drive is pushed on this guy. Oh well, at least this we tried.
Sure. Alright, so we're just gonna call it a day for now and then we'll go from there.
Yeah. Thanks for watching.